yesterday when we made the table. Can you find, I asked you to copy the table yesterday, find the table. Let me do it.
Miss Jesus.
You mean three times three?
Yeah.
Yeah, they could just stuff
from yesterday.
I got it, miss.
Hearing some actual good conversation. When you ask each other math questions, that's great. I love to hear a fraction. So remember, negative exponents make fractions, not negative numbers. So 3 to the negative 2, that's plugging in correctly. You put it under 1, negative 2 positive. 3 squared is 9, so this is 1/9. Well, I mean, I got a flat point here, so in your calculator, what is 1 divided by 9? What? 0.1?
Yeah.
All right, so we got to make a big dot.
It's repeating.
-2, 0.1. You can, but I also said when you flat points, if you want a decimal, you can. Alright, I'll show you. 3 to the negative 1 is not negative 3. It is 1 over 3, 1/3. Does anybody have the decimal for 1/3 memorized?
It's
4/3. Yeah. So my next point, just a little bit higher. Mine looks like it's halfway. The best I can do. 3 to the 0 power. 1. Mm-hmm.
How do you graph it?
Is it 3 over 1? So you go 3 over 1?
Huh?
Are you talking about 0.3? For this is 1, 3, that one. It's an ordered pair, x, y. This is it. This looks just like 2 to the x, but right here, if the base was 2, then that point would be 1, 2. So since it's 1, since the base is 3, then it's 1, 3. If the base is 5, it would be 1, 5. Nonlinear function. Are we ready for number 2?
Yes.
I am. Alright, so how would we write an equation just like number 1, but it's supposed to be down 5 units? It would be y equals 3 to the x, and up or down shows up in the k spot.
Also, we gotta read right now.
Anything here moves an up down. So if I want to go down 5, I'm gonna do a minus and a 5 at the end. Yep.
Okay, just side to side.
Yeah, it's just side to side. Like H for horizontal, K is vertical.
Oh, we're on 13. So
I'm going to take all the same values from number 1 and I'm going to move them down 5. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's nice to look at a table, I'll show you.
But you still use
negative 2, negative 1, 0.2, right? Like, let's say I use the table in number 1.
Could it be like?
Which was negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2. And then I got 0.1, 0.3, 1, 3, 9. Now if I just minus 5 from all of those. 4, negative 2, negative 4. 0.3 minus 5. So to be honest with you, this is like the real kind of advanced way to do it, is to show it in a table. Like, wow, I'm taking these and I'm minusing 5. If you don't want to do that, you can just copy the points and just count them down 5. And that's really at level for algebra 1. I minus 5. So I took these y's and I minus 5. From each y value. So the red one here is the parent, y equals 3 to the x. If I plot these new ones, oh, I should switch the colors.
I can't see that.
And I just count down 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
So what, Lisa, you gotta rewrite both of them? Or if you just write both?
You don't have to redraw number 1 here. Becca and Laura, you're both asking me, do you have to draw the red, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You, it's not required, though I think it's helpful. Like, I do it because it helps me, you know? So this was number 1, and this is just every point I can just count down 5. Or, that's the same as taking my table, subtracting 5 from every y value, and plotting these points. The blue paired with the red would give me down 5 as well. Those are both. Now, when you want me to zoom in, you're telling me to zoom in on the picture, right? I would rather you look at your picture, if you have the red, and count each one down 5 yourself. Instead of trying to see where my points landed, you should count down 5 from your points. Write an equation for number 1 is write 4 units and then graph. So here's number 1. Right and left should show up high with the exponent. So there's right 4. No. So this is the model, right? And there's already a minus sign there. So I'm just plugging a 4 in for H. So the minus sign is just there. It looks like minus 4, but I put a positive 4 in. Well, if I was to go left, I would put a negative 4 in. And then minus the negative would make it look positive.
Wait, so why are you putting?
He looks like him.
So you would say,
yeah, but the minus 4 is all pi with the exponent.
So then we got a minus exponent.
Yeah.
But we're still using the same points, though, right?
Yeah, we can. Like here, I have the parent function. Like, now I can just count every point right 4.
I need to write it out. I need to see it. Mm-hmm.
And there's the shift right for the rewind. Now here's what the table would look like. Understanding the table is kind of advanced, kind of extra. Knowing that that minus 5 is right 4, that's on my left. Understanding how to shift the table, that's a little difficult. But I'm showing you anyway. This is the basic, apparent. 0.1, 0.3,
0.3. Those are repeating.
So I would add 4 here, so negative 2 plus 4 is 2, 3, 4, 5, and 7. So those are the new x values. To shift the graphs, to shift your graph right or left, you change x's. So if I add 4 to each of these are my new ordered pairs. I could check it out. Now, I didn't use the table to make my picture. I just counted right 4. So is this true? Is my first point at 2.1? Yes. 3.3? Yes. 4.1? Yes. 5.3? Yes. So I took the basic one and moved it right. Got these points. And I can see that in my table, if I just add 4 to my x, I'm just going to do 4 next to him. We haven't really done one. That's it. Are you sure you can do a reflection? You feel good about that?
She can't.
I said 5 and 6.
5 and 6 are reflections.
No, they're not.
No, just 4 is. Okay. Am I good? Alright, so to do a reflection, it would be y equals negative 3 to the x. And I like to see that. That's actually negative 1 times 3 to the x. I think that life would be much more clear if it was written like it is on the right. The negative 1 is like out in front. It's not negative 3. It's negative 1 times 3.
Bless you.
So here's the parent. A reflection just flips down. There's my reflection. Now let's take a look at the more advanced table. If I forget, you can email me. So visually, a reflection is just flipped. For the table, which again is the kind of extra advanced way, if I was to actually multiply every y, it's just like multiplying each one by negative 1. So instead of 0.1, like we've been doing, it's negative 0.1. Instead of 0.3, it's negative 0.3. Instead of 1, it's negative 1. Instead of 3, it's negative 3. Instead of 9, it's negative 9. So you can check your reflection and see, like, are those the points that you plotted?
Yeah, the green is the answer. The red is the basic.
We don't have time to do far with any six. That's
I
the
totally
question.
Agree.
I ain't trying to be bad.
Oh, no, we don't have
time. All right, let's do
1/3. Can we do 6? Let's get to 6.
Yeah,
let's
do
6.
6
look a little harder. You got a little extra letters and numbers and all that. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
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 All right, this is a baby step less than 1. Instead of the arrow going up, it should slope down. It should show a decrease instead of an increase. So if you look at all of the reds are increasing. The reflection's not, but all the rest are. If I put a little guy here, it should start high and go low. We'll see how it goes. Okay, same table. Alright, this time we're doing 3 × 1/3 to the x. So 3 × 1/3 to the negative 2, that's going to be a huge number. That's 3 × 1/-2 / 3 / -2.
Oh, man, you're trying to do this one work, but it's not really.
You still have one problem.
Exactly, but it's not hard. It's not really don't.
She said leave your book out for me.
I did leave my book out. This is the book she's talking about. How about you?
Oh, exactly.
Wow, negative numbers make fractions, right? So if I have a negative outside of here, that goes 1 - 2 - 3 - 2. No big deal. But negatives, you have to change the spot. So I'm going to put the 3 up top. The 2 goes positive. I put the 1 down low. The 1 goes positive. And then 3 squared is 9. So 3 times 9 is 27. So your first order here is
1 or 6 7 7 10 2 1 or 6 7 7
You guys looked at a system and I forgot.
Baseball tryouts start Monday.
I'm not saying you're gonna do it wrong.
I'll try out start